Moet je, big boy.
Oh, yeah, you're getting big. You're a big boy. Oh, big boy. Oh, yes, you're a very big boy. Oh, big boy. Oh, yeah, you're a big boy. Oh, yeah. Big boy.
Oh, yeah. You're a big horsey. Jesus Christ, you're getting big.
Oh. Big boy.
Yeah. Oh boy. Oh, big boy. Okay. That's enough. Oh, we get.
Oh, Jesus. What a shit horsey.
Okay, buddy. Here we go. Yep. Monster boy, oh, come back to me. All right, buddy. Okay, Jesus, you're a horse now.
Whoa, this, I can't, holy, look at this monster. Okay, please stop growing. That's enough out of you, mister.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Fudgy. Fudgy, sit, sit, stay, stay, stay. Happy birthday, sit, stay, 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 stay. Happy birthday to you. Good boy. Eat your birthday cake. Eat your birthday cake. There you go. I was gonna make him a cake, but I realized that I don't actually have any cake tins because I don't bake cakes. And I know this candle says 8, but Fudgy can't tell the difference anyways. So he's ate in his own heart. So what you saw for Fudgy's birthday cake was actually some of his raw food patties with a candle on it. I've been giving him raw food since he's been about 5 months old, and he's been totally great with it. The vet is actually really happy with how Fudgy's been going as well. I've been warned that some people don't like the idea of feeding their dogs raw food. I've never met any of these people in person, but I'm sure I will in the comments. Fudgy is really healthy and he's actually really well behaved compared to other golden retriever puppies I know. I'm not gonna name any names, but you know who you are. Jasper, who shat in my house 4 times in one day. Fudgy don't shit in my house 4 times in one day. Fudgy eats raw food. And Fudgy's so much happier eating raw food as well. I remember the first time I gave it to him, he ran up to me afterwards and snuggled. He was so happy, I could see a smile on his face. He really likes this a lot more than dry kibble.
Fudgy seems to be doing this really happy wiggle after getting his first bit of raw food.
I was worried that maybe it won't be enough for him, that he won't grow enough, but the vet says that he's very well within his healthy range and he's very lean because he's so active. Every morning I would take him for a walk through Evergreen Brickworks. We'd walk for around 45 minutes to an hour and he'd run up the hills and he'd chase squirrels and like run with other dogs, and he's off leash and he's very well behaved. He doesn't do very many tricks. I could show you some of them, except he just ate, so he's not really that motivated to do tricks anymore. Okay, sit, paw, other paw, good, down, down, crawl, crawl, good boy, good crawl, yes, we're good boy, yes, and now, edit the video, edit this video, edit this video. He's also fixed now. I wasn't originally planning on getting him fixed. I wanted to avoid it for as long as I could, but when Petra came into my life, she was in heat and Fudgy lost his f-ing mind. He was drooling everywhere, just puddles of drool, and he'd follow her everywhere and lick her. And I mean, lick her. It was gross. I couldn't keep them apart. I tried putting them in separate rooms and he just bark all the time. The neighbors called and complained, so I got him fixed and he's not a crazy asshole anymore.
No, you're not, you sweet boy.
I also noticed that I talk different alone with him than I do when other people are around.
Okay, Fudgy, sit, sit. Good boy, behave, good boy.
But when friends aren't around.
Oh yes, who is my big bopas?
Yes, that's right. Fudgy is the big bopas. I don't know what that means. It just came to me naturally and it stuck. Speaking of friends, I've been working on a new project. It goes live June 22nd and it's called A Life With Friends. As some of you might know, Martina and I have separated and it's been a hell of a year for me, as those of you who have gone through divorces might have experienced for yourself. It ain't easy. It ain't fun. So I decided to take a year off so I could take care of myself, heal, learn, and grow. And I was sharing that in my last video in November, which seemed to freak out a few people who thought I was in a death cult. I am not in any death cult, okay? That's not possible. We're in the middle of a pandemic. The government has locked everything down. You can't gather more than 10 people. That's not a cult. That's a small circle. Wait until the government allows people to join cults again and then check in on me. Point is, in this year, I've changed a lot. I have very different views of life now, and I'm going to share these views with a friend of mine on this podcast called A Life With Friends. We spend a whole episode talking about meditation, another whole episode we're discussing our experiences with therapy, and another episode we're discussing compassion. And really, what does the word compassion mean? I remember being told it as a kid. I was never taught what it actually means. How can somebody be more compassionate? What does that even look like? I think these are valid questions to ask, and so I'm trying to tackle a lot of them in this podcast. It always feels good for me if I could get someone else's perspective on anything that they're an expert in and see how can I apply that. I don't have to fully subscribe to their belief, but is there a piece of that that I could take for myself? How can I take little bits everywhere that I go and like have a richer, more complete version of myself? We're also running a book club on this podcast. I've always wanted to run a book club. We're opening up a Discord channel where hopefully we could keep this discussion going. The whole thing is being run ad-free. If you listen to the podcast and if you like it, which I hope you will, consider joining us on Patreon. 10% of our proceeds are going to charity. We're alternating charities every month. I've got my mind on effective altruism, and I actually kind of want to talk a little bit more about that in the future too. It's really hard filming with a dog as he keeps on coming in and out of the shot and ruining my continuity. The first episode airs on June 22nd, or if you're a patron, on June 21st. Give it a listen. I hope you like it. I'm really proud of it. I've been thinking about it for a long time and I've been putting a lot of work into this, and this is something that I'm comfortable doing in the future. Okay, enough talk about that. Back to Fudgy and his sisters. Come here, little pet. So this here is little Petra.
Petra, you have such a spots. What are you doing with your face? What are you doing with your face and your nice paws? Nice face and nice paws. Oh yes, who has the nice paws? Whose paws are so nice? Whose paws are so nice? Show me those nice paws. What are you doing with those nice paws? Who has the nicest paws? Fudgy, no lover.
Me and the shelter are guessing that she's around 2 years old. We're not too sure. She's a poodle something mix, but she came from a puppy mill and she had a really rough time there, and she was like pretty traumatized from it. When I first met her, she was even scared to go on walks, but now she loves going on walks, and she has a good role model in Fudgy, who's like teaching her how to be very puppy-like. I even heard her bark for the first time a couple days ago, and Fudgy's gonna teach her a whole bunch of new tricks, like eating my expensive shoes, and then eating a whole rotisserie chicken when I turn my back, and then barfing on my goddamn books. Are you gonna teach that to Petra? No, you're not, you sweet boy. Here is Roxy. Hey, little Roxy. Hello, show them your sweet little bootsies. Ba, 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 ba. So Roxy isn't actually a permanent part of the family. She's a foster dog, and I'm bringing her back to Toronto this weekend to give her to her new forever home. But I've had her for a couple of months, and I love her, and I'm really gonna miss her. And it was really nice for Fudgy to have a little sister. Oh, and I have a turtle. Her name is Gertrude. Yes, I have a lot of animals in my life. This is the new me. I just like animals. They provide comfort, and I love them. Don't dig too deep into this. Don't try to psychoanalyze me. Don't try to figure anything out, Sherlock, okay? There's nothing more for you to see here. This is my little video. I hope you liked it. Please be nice in the comments, and I'll see you in the future. And catch. Yum, 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 yum. Yum, 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 yum. You missed it. No more.